Well, there were emotional scenes at Pike River Mine today, with families of the 29 victims allowed deep into the mine's drift for the first time.
Relatives were transported almost 200 metres inside to the final remaining seal as the ongoing re-entry effort edges towards completion. Thomas Mead was there.
A quiet moment between a mother and son. Sonia Rockhouse holding her boy Daniel tight. He survived the explosion, but those flowers are for her other 21-year-old son Ben, who didn't make it out. Together they climb aboard to travel into the mine, which became his tomb.
I put my face against the wall so that, I could be as close as I could be.
The journey to a seal at the 170-metre mark is the closest the Pike River families have been able to get to their lost men since the explosion in 2010. With the first seal at 30 metres already removed, it's the final obstacle in the 2.3-kilometre-long main access tunnel.
The personal nature of today's visit aside, this is a hugely significant moment. It shows the first phase of the recovery is now being completed, and the teams here are confident that they can push past that final barrier and, at last, re-enter the drift.
All that's needed now is the final health and safety clearance from WorkSafe.
WorkSafe have said they'll give it high priority, and they are giving it high priority.
26 family members took the opportunity to go inside today, including widow Anna Osborne.
It's the closest I've been to milk for nearly 9 years now, and it was an experience I'll never forget and one I'll always appreciate.
Anna and I were bawling our eyes out. We were sort of overcome with emotion, really.
It was an especially important moment for Anna, who's due to start stem cell treatment for lymphoma tomorrow. She took time in the drift today to send her husband, Milton, a message.
I hope he's proud of what we're doing, because we won't give up. They deserve so much better.
And now, after all those years of fighting, the stage is finally set. The re-entry of the Pike River Drift is just around the corner. Thomas Mead, One News.